How's your energy situation? Are you already off-grid? Do you like to be more independent from the energy supplier? In the last video, I talked about how to stay cool with solar energy. In this video, I will show you how to barbecue, to make coffee, tea, pasta, and maybe even an air fryer just with a sand battery. It's an evolution of last year. Last year, I made this battery here. Very primitive, even if there is a copper pipe which goes through the sand to pick up the heat. But now we go to the multifunctional stuff. I will tell you how I plan to make a barbecue, an oven, and a place, a furnace where to put a pot and a pan on it. So watch this video and learn how to drink and eat with a very simple solar cooking system and replace the barbecue, the furnace, natural gas, and also the oven. There's a video where I talked about this device, the old wood stove of our grandmothers. I mean the grandmother of my generation. Well, this works of course on wood. And it is multifunctional because you can put pot and pans on it. You can cook also water on it, but the water can be cooked also here because this is a water container. And here's the oven. So this is really multifunctional. Now I want to make this not with wood, but with sand. And why with sand and not with wood? Well, first, because there are many people with the PV installations in developed countries have a hard time to sell it to the grid for a few dimes. And they would like to have some kind of flexible way to absorb all this energy in a useful way so that it stays in home. Another reason is that now if you look to the developing countries, then you have much more sun than you have wood, and people have often to go around and harvest wood which is not there, and they have to look for it many hours there. That's also not good for the few trees which are there. And now you have a solar panel of 400 watts that I bought at 86 euros. That lasts 20 years or so. You have 20 years solar energy, which you can also store, not in the wood, because wood takes many years to grow, but to store in sand. It's 25 kilos. And in fact, it is not sand, but it is pebbles. We'll talk about that later. Anyway, my idea for the developing countries would be that you take such a panel and you have, for example, 400 watts. Then you could make some 2 kilowatt hours at the end of the day. And you store it in sand or in pebbles. And then you have at the end of the day, you have all this heat stored, 2 kilowatt hours, that you can use for clean cooking. Yes, this sand and or the pebbles, they are also a kind of thermal battery, and you can heat it up to 400, 500 degrees. And if you build a little bit of things around it, so I have here my last year's sand battery. Attracted 18,000 views from last year to now. You see it has a rock wool as the insulation, so I don't know, it depends also on the materials you use, but how much time it will remain, but maybe it will also remain overnight, and then the morning after you can continue to build up your heat in this sand battery. I bought some materials and I just wanted to experiment a little bit. So this is a couple of euros. Then you have this, and maybe this could also function as an insulation material. I don't know how much fireproof it is, but then I bought also, well, to start with, 15 of these bricks. They resist until 960 degrees Celsius. So that's like the base on which I built the oven. And then I bought this. It has only four channels. It can also be insulation material. But anyway, I think it's a good wall for the at the front and the back of this oven, of this sand center. These channels you saw in these bricks, they can also have a function to heat up air, and then the air will be blown on the on one side and come out hot at the other side with maybe more or less a controlled temperature. And then you can maybe use it for an oven or so. My idea was it to start with this simple configuration. So you see here two layers. You see here heat resistant brick on the base. And then you see here this bricks with channels. And I would put one on the other. And then put a kind of iron wire. And then tend it with this device here, with this screw. And then that will hold 360 degrees, this layer and the under layer together. Well, it's just a prototype. Then in some way I would divide this. If I fill it up with sand or pebbles or both. Hey Charlie, you are thinking also already about the meat, about the barbecue. Yes, barbecue, that's one of the things which I want to realize. For example, I would make the barbecue in the center or so, and here a place for the pots. And then you see just here the surface of the pebbles or the sand is just visible. And then you can put maybe the pots just on the sand or maybe a grid above it. For the barbecue, you need, of course, a grid. You have to take care what will happen with the fat. That's a dripstone from the meat. Here I would maybe make a kind of oven. And then think about a way that if I put here pebbles that can conduct air, the air can go relatively easy, and then it can get into the oven room. And I must think still how to make this oven. Then of course, as there is not to be expected very high temperature here, I can insulate that. And then I can also put different lids on it from iron, and then after that from rock wool or so. And then it is insulated for the time that you don't use it, and that it is accumulating heat from the resistive elements. And then only when you need it, then you can take the lid off. And then you can use or the barbecue or the stove or the oven. And this oven can, if you conduct well the air, the hot air, then it can even get to become an air fryer. Because, you know, an air fryer is nothing else than oven with intensive ventilation. So then we come to the discussion between the sand or the pebbles. Here you see the pebbles with 14 to 28 millimeters. So they are a little bit big, but they will allow to get air through it very easily. And as you see, a lava stone. And that means there is no risk with the explosion of normal pebbles, which might explode if exposed to very high temperatures. For example, if you are at the bottom of a river and you take the pebbles from there You don't know what it is and you don't know how it behaves. But these pebbles have been exposed very recently to very high temperatures, so that could not be a problem. Then I want to make some experiments with these pebbles. And Charlie's also very curious. He says, okay, Dad, where's the scent? Okay, the scent is here. And I want to learn more about how it behaves. What's the difference? But I have already an idea that scent conducts slow the heat because there's no air which I can run through it, like with the pebbles. But it will have its own benefits. For example, that it might have a little bit more of heat. It will have a little bit more weight per liter. And also it retains the heat better. But okay, I will not start with the multifunctional energy center, but I would maybe start with the small square here. And then I would fill it with only pebbles. And then in some way I would try to get air from the underside in this space. Maybe by using this kind of brick, which I put here, somewhere here. And then I can push air inside. Or maybe it will just go by itself and it goes into the oven. And then it will be drawn from here inside. And here are my resistive elements. So this is already a broken hairdryer. And here you see the fan. I am curious if this fan still functions. And here is then the resistive elements. And I can put it just into sand. But I also ordered for 25 meters of this kind of wire. And then I could use this block to go up and down with the wires so that they don't touch each other. Because if they touch each other, then you will have a short circuit and the current will go the shortest distance. So the wires must not touch each other. And that's easy to do with this. And then you fill this with the sand. So here's another resistor elements here inside, which I can use. And this is another, a broken iron. So I can use that. Then about the question, how can you use this in developing countries and how you can use it in developed countries? Well, in developing countries, I told already that you have with 70 euros, 400 volt, and you have 2 kilowatt hour per day of sun electricity. And then you can store that in a sand. And then you can avoid to go around for biomass. And I think it's very safe. If you compare it with the smoky stoves and the fires which they use now. If you're talking about developed countries, then I think about use the PV electricity. That many people in many countries now complain that the energy supply is less willing to give a good payment for this electricity. So it's more and more every year more. It is more convenient to keep this electricity in the house. And this is a way to do this because you can put as many resistive wire in it and switch on as you want. In our case, that 3.5 kilowatt is going into the grid. And it's a contribution to the society because it's somewhere in the grid it will be used in a good way. In developed countries, how you can use it, as I said, you just collect the electricity, the heat in the sand, and then you use it for a barbecue, for making water, for making pasta, pizzas, meat, soup, and also coffee and tea, of course. My first experiment could be that I make a very small stove where you put this mocha, this typical Italian coffee maker, you put on it. So I am convinced that the applications are many in all the world, in the whole world. The collateral benefit for the developing countries is, of course, that you have this panel, and it will stay there for 20 years or so. And you can use the current electricity also for other things. If you want to know more about this and also about the experiments, which I will make after this video, because there was no time, and I made also a PDF on the thermal energy storage, not in sand but in water, and I have been working on that. And in the last video, you can actually download a PDF, a guide about how to build that and how to use it. But now I'm inviting you to go in the description to see the link how to download the PDF, what are the possibilities of this sand battery, or also of the pebble battery if you want. And I think I saw very little videos about the combination of pebbles and sand, the difference between the benefits of the one and the other. And also I saw little videos about how you can make sand energy center, so a multifunctional construction which is very simple and which is very practical. You can use it in many ways. The only thing you need is this. Then you need this, a couple of these types of stones. Then you need this, and you need this is sand instead of pebbles. And then you need a little bit of resistance wire. So if you want to know more about that and what are the possible applications and how to use it also to absorb your electricity, your excess electricity, which you want to keep in your house, then go and download this PDF and join also the club with the newsletter, because every week I publish very interesting things about energy, home, do it yourself. I wish you a good week. Stay calm, stay cool, and stay healthy. I wish you good energy.